empathy exercise. If you've ever had trouble working out how and what to say in your ads and your marketing communication and things like that, then this is the little exercise you need to take yourself through. Do take the time to do it and do it well, because it literally does hone you in like, I don't know, tuning a radio station. It gets you right on the right frequency if done right. So what is it? It's basically a mind reading exercise to help you resonate with your buyers. So just a reminder, a big picture how this fits in. You've got your market that you operate in, and hopefully you've watched the video on the how to identify your niche markets. And there might be little pockets of buyers within your market where there's far more money to be made than just generally swimming around the big ocean. And then you've got your marketing system, which we're going to develop, and you need ways to get these people within these niches into your marketing system. So you might use one step, two step, three step. If you don't know what those terms are, don't worry, we'll get to that soon. But anyway, you need a way to communicate to them so that you resonate with them and they want to come into your marketing system. They want to connect and engage with you. So what's the secret to marketing? Well, really find out what people want and give it to them. That's one secret. And that's basically what marketing is really find out what people want and give it to them. I mean, it is as simple as that. And most people don't really know what their target market wants, so it makes it pretty hard to give it to them. Right? If we give them stuff around it, stuff close, but not quite exactly what they want. Here's another secret, and this really just helps you find out what people want and giving it to them. So that's the main one. But into the conversation that the customer's already having. There's a famous copywriter early in the 19th century, a guy called Robert Collier, and he came up with this term, enter the conversation the customer's already having. So you've got to think like them, basically. If you want to sell what Jane Smith buys, you need to see the world through Jane Smith's eyes. And this little exercise will help you do that. So why is it important? You've got to connect with your audience if you're going to get them to engage with you. So people connect with people that they know, like, and trust. You've got to be like them, or you've got to be someone they want to be. Either someone they want to be or someone they like who they feel is like them. So it's a bit like tuning a radio station where what you say needs to perfectly connect with the right frequency. As you know, with a radio, you can be close to the frequency but slightly off it, and there's a whole lot of static and maybe you can't quite hear the sounds and the music coming through. But if you just adjust it slightly, just those subtle little changes, all of a sudden the sound starts to flow through and everything becomes obvious and communication starts to happen. But it is fine-tuning. So this is about getting under the skin of your best buyers. You've got to speak like them, think like them, feel like them, so that they know you're not a fraud. Now, just to give an example that maybe not everyone can relate to, but if someone was selling me some cricket stuff, some cricket gear, and they started to use the wrong words. For example, they talked about pitching the ball. You know, you often speak to a lot of people and, you know, I love the way you guys pitch the ball down really fast. Well, as soon as someone uses the term, say, pitch the ball down fast, or it hits the sticks at the end, you immediately know they're not a cricketer and you immediately know they're not like you. If you know what I mean, there's terms within each little niche that people in the niche use those terms, and other people don't. And that's just an example, I guess, of you've got to say the right things in the right way, using the right words to connect so that they know you are one of them. So you've got to do a little bit of research. But here's a little exercise. I want to just take you through the logistics of it and then tell you an amazing little story. So this is called the Avatar Instant Empathy Exercise, how to write a killer ad. So the key with this is when you think about the database of people you have or you want to have, it contains people. It's not a list. It contains individual people, and they're all different. They've all got their own problems and desires. And when you're communicating with people in marketing, you've really got to think about communicating with one person. If you think about communicating with a list of 500 people, or 30 people, or 20 people even, it doesn't work as well. You've got to be speaking as if you're speaking to one person. So as I'm saying this, I'm imagining I'm speaking to one person at the moment, and I won't say who it is, but it's a person who is a client who I've just sort of pictured, and I'm telling the story to her. And it just makes it easier, right? So it doesn't matter who I'm speaking to, but just you take your target market and you take someone within your niche market and pick out one. Maybe they're a current customer or they're an identity of someone you want to get. And I want you to imagine a single person who represents your target market. Now give them a name. And it could be an imaginary person. It could be someone, you could be making this person up who represents this ideal person. But give them a name. Give them a gender. Give them an age. Give them an appearance. Just to visualize what that person looks like. Give them an occupation. Just think that one through. Now, this may take a little more effort, but write down the beliefs and attitudes and maybe the values that this person has and really start to resonate with that. Now, this will take some time. I'm not going to do it now, but just do this exercise. Trust me, it makes it so much easier. And when I tell you the amazing story, you'll get the picture. Write down, well, ask them, if you don't already know, what are some of the words they use or the language or sayings or the common terms within that group of people, that niche of people that they would use? And get those down so that you can start to use those words. What are some of their traits? Are they married? Are they single? They got kids? What are their scars from the past? Are they rich or poor? This is a single person, remember. Now make this person up. If it's not a real customer who you can pinpoint, start to create an avatar of this person. And give them a little story so that you can really relate to that one person. And then genuinely seek to help them achieve their goals. Okay, let's say the name of this person was Sally. And you've worked out what their name is, their gender, their age, their occupation, their beliefs, their problems, their desires, the traits they have, who they are, what they're doing in their life at the moment, what they're thinking about, what they're worried about. And you're genuinely looking to help them achieve their goals. That's when you get paid. That's when ads start to do really well. Okay, so you get the idea. And then when you write an ad, you write it to Sally. Now, I had a Sally. Let me tell you a little story. This is kind of amazing, and you may not believe me, but it's true. So I had this house, and this is a house in Wellington, and it's a rental property. And we own the downstairs part of this big Wellington building. It's 3-bedroom downstairs, nice place, great view overlooking the harbour. Fireworks come on. It's like a corporate box for the fireworks display over the harbour. Brilliant. So anyway, I've had it filled with pretty average tenants for quite a while. And not only that, it's a reasonably nice place, but the location's fantastic and the view's brilliant. And I kept getting these guys who didn't really look after it, you know, blue tack, or turn up and there's blue tack over the wall. The worst guys I had, they got behind in their rent. I go around there, I have to go see them a few times. One of the neighbours comes across at one stage and says, oh, look, you know, I've been away over in England for a while, and they said, you're probably not aware, but these guys next door have been having big parties. One night for a weekend, they even had a sheep on the deck. Now, here's the deck up here. They had a sheep on the deck. They said, we're really worried about the sheep and all this type of stuff. Well, I kicked them out and I got some other guys in who were a bit hairy and didn't look like they were washed that often. And I'm thinking, this is just crazy. It's a really nice house. And I keep getting guys in the house. And I thought, what would I want? You know, who do I want? Because I probably need to do this avatar exercise and get someone who I really want. And you know, because obviously I'm not writing the ads to attract them. And I thought, okay, well, the house next door to where I live always had really good tenants, and it was always predominantly young, 20-something-year-old woman who were professionals. And I thought, that is what I want. You know, they don't make much fuss. They generally don't have big parties. They're clean and tidy. They want a wee nest, the nice place to live in. So I want someone like the girls next door. So I didn't know them very well, but I could just see they were young professionals and all that type of stuff. So I want a sort of a 27-year-old Sally who maybe she's a lawyer. She takes care of herself, takes care of her surroundings. They want to live in a nice place and, yeah, basically want to live in a nice place and they're clean and tidy and all that type of stuff. So I write this ad and here's the ad. Now, bear in mind, this is on Trade Me. So it didn't look like this, but it was written up and just copied and pasted because I'm going to save this little one for later. It worked a treat. Okay, so here's the headline. They laughed when I read out my dream rental property requirements. Here's what I want in a property. Must have great views, preferably Oriental Bay. That's convenient because that's what they've got. So when I come home, I can chill out, looking over the harbour with a glass of wine and instantly unwind from the busy day. So I'm writing this for a 28-year-old professional, Sally, who's a lawyer and who wants to flat with a couple of other similar type girlfriends. Needs to be close enough to the city that I can power walk to work around Oriental Parade and keep trim without getting bored. Must have a garage and free street parking. Now, bear in mind, obviously, these are all the things I have, but I'm writing it from Sally's point of view, as I think she might try and say it. Now, obviously, I'm not a Sally, and maybe my ads in the past have been written for guys, you know, I guess 20-year-old versions or 22-year-old versions of me, which I wouldn't really want me as a 20-year-old flatting in this place, but that's what I've been attracting because I've probably been writing it from my point of view. Number four, must have a bus stop within 10 metres just in case the morning power walk is called off due to rain. We don't want to drive, too expensive to park. Now, these are some of the things I'm thinking that a 28-year-old Sally, 26-year-old, 26 I was thinking really, 26-year-old Sally would be thinking. Number five, let's see. We need a deck for entertaining friends, preferably overlooking the harbour too. Make it big. Okay, so I'm just putting down all the stuff I think a 26-year-old Sally would want. If we have views, we want to be perfectly placed for the harbour fireworks displays. Seven, I want three bedrooms with a decent cupboard space. Eight, yes, sun. We want to be west-facing with a sunny, dry, warm house. Whoops. Nine, house needs to have character and charm. 1920s was a good era. 10, oh yes, it needs to be on the best street in Wellington. Location. So these are all the features I had, and I've tried to put them in the perspective of a 26-year-old professional woman. I think I mentioned that. 11, all this must be well under $600 per week because I need to save for my overseas holiday. Now I'm thinking, 26-year-old woman who's a professional, going on holiday is one of the big things she wants to do for the year. Is that too much to ask? 11 simple things is the question. Hey, if this is the dream list, you might write, then be quick to move. If this is a dream list, you might write, then be quick to move. I haven't read this for a while. So this is me talking to them. This is a very cool 1900s property with the best view over Oriental Bay ever invented. It's probably not perfect, but it is close. The carpets are lit now. Here's where I'm trying to, I don't want to think it's perfect because when they turn up, you know what I mean? I don't want them to run away. So here's where I'm just playing it down a little bit. It's probably not perfect, but close. The carpet's a little worn in parts, and the kitchen is a little dated. If you can handle jealous friends, then move quickly. Now I'm thinking too, a 26-year-old professional Sally wants her friends to go, wow, what a cool place. Okay, so I'll throw it in there. Call Richard on this number, and I can show you around Saturday early afternoon. Outstanding. Right, so let's try that. This is an ad written for a 26-year-old woman, not for the guys I've been getting. Now, the interesting thing was, by, I don't know, about 9:30, I'd received 8 phone calls, all from 20-something-year-old women. No guys. No guys had called me up. I went round there. The first woman I met, she was about 26. She was exactly the type I had been imagining, very similar to what I perceived the girls next door, you know, were sort of like. And I signed her up, and, you know, sort of signed her up immediately. She had to chat with her friends. I had another six or seven people come through that flat within the next hour, and they're all similar type of woman. flirting with other women, they were all good. And the first 6 out of 8 said they wanted the place. Now, I had trouble in the past. I don't know. It would have taken me in the past for about that sort of rent. I would have had to show it to 6 or 7 people. Most of them would have been guys. And one of them would have said, yeah, I'll take it. Okay, 6 or 7 guys. This one I showed to 8 women and 6 of them wanted to take it immediately. Okay, so incredible. Complete. I was attracting the right target market, the right person. And it was being marketed in a way that they wanted it. So anyway, so I call this girl up and say, great, it's yours. Come round to my house. We'll do the paperwork. I want to sign them up. So I had about another 5 on waiting list in case they didn't want it. So that was cool. I was pretty much covered there. She says, okay, where do you live? And I say, okay, I'm in Rata Road. Oh, she said, so are we. I said, oh, you're joking. I said, well, I'm at this number. I said, what number are you? She said, the number in the house right beside us. Right? Now, she was getting the flat on behalf of the 3 girls that were living in the house right beside me, the ones that I had imagined writing the ad for because I wanted a woman like that. It's unbelievable. I didn't know what they looked like or anything like that. I'd only seen them from a distance going in and out. I know it's completely ignorant, but that was them, and they rented the place. So I know it seems strange but true, but that's the power of doing this exercise. I couldn't believe it. She was blown away because they didn't recognize me, and they'd been living beside us for a year, and I didn't recognize them, and I'd been living beside them for a year, and just an incredible, well, I think it's an incredible story. So exactly the girls I'd been writing for. Oh, by the way, one of them was a 26-year-old lawyer, one of the flatmates. So truth is stranger than fiction, right? So anyway, I'd done this exercise on myself for this flat. So it's a pretty funny example, but that's what you get. So those are the details. That's what, you know, there's a bit more you can add. You could have 11 or 12 or 15 different attributes you wanted to have in there, particularly the way they think and they feel. But ask yourself these questions, put yourself through this exercise, and what it will do is make ad writing really simple, because you'll know what to say, how to say it. You'll know the things, the problems to address, the desires to build into it, the objections they may have, because you're dealing with a specific Sally or a Bruce or whatever it is you're going to do. So that's the exercise. Get on to it now. That story I just told you is 100% true. It still blows my mind. But anyway, have a good day. Get on to the exercise now and get into it, because it'll make your life a whole lot easier and your ads a whole lot more effective.